In the following tutorial, we're going to talk about stone counts and saving our graphic. So what you see right here is a rhinestone pattern. It's composed of vector artwork as well as the rhinestone pattern itself, which is a combination of circles. So if I select F9 on my keyboard, I can see the outline view or contour view, and I can actually see the vector graphics. To return to the normal view, I can just press F9 on my keyboard again. So one of the things that I might want to do with this graphic is turn off the vector artwork, but I want to keep it around for later purposes. Maybe I want to do a variation of this design. So what I can do is I can go over to the color layer docker. I can right mouse click on that color layer. I can say not visible. And then I can do the same thing with the citrine layer. I'm going to right mouse click. I'm going to say not visible, and then we'll press OK. Now you're noticing there's quite a few colors that are listed here in the layer list that aren't being used in my graphic. And if I want to go ahead and delete those colors, I can left mouse click on this little arrow over here, and I can say delete unused layers. So there's our graphic. Now, what if we want to go and find out the number of stones by size and color in this particular graphic? There's a couple different ways to do it. One way to do it would be to select the color layer. So I could go over here to the sun layer and just select it. Go over here and hit the SEL button to select the entire layer. And then down here in the status bar, it's going to display the number of stones. In this case, 64 stones. And I can do the same thing with the amethyst layer. Select it, hit SEL, and there's going to be 22 stones there. Now, the other way I can do that is I can go over here to the objects docker, and we can see that count here. In fact, we can select those stones right in the objects docker. So it says rhinestone. We can select that. We can see that's the purple layer. There's 22 stones. And again, we have 64 stones in the sun-colored layer. So what we're going to do next is we're going to go ahead and we're going to save this design. So I'm going to go over here and I'm going to select File, Save. I'm going to locate an area on my hard drive where I'd like to save the file. And one of the things that I'm probably going to do is I'm going to add all of my job information so it's connected with the saved file. And you notice here's the date. Here's the name of the company that produced it. Also, we can include various pricing information. We can put an order number in here. We can put the customer in here. And we can put all of their contact information, emails. In fact, what we can do is we can come over here and we can put the stone counts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say SS6, which is our layer for sun. And that particular layer has 64 stones. And then what we're going to do is we're going to come in here. We're going to say SS10. And that layer is amethyst. And we're going to put in 22. So at this point, we've saved our stone counts with the design. Once we click on OK, then we can find a location where we want to save this design. We'll just go ahead and put it on the desktop. We can name it. And we'll name this design Diamond. We're going to save it as a job file, which is the native file format for stone cut. We'll click on Save. And then we've saved the file. Now, what if I want to save a variation of the file? If I want to make changes to this file and change it and create a variation, let's say I want to delete this layer here, I'll just select it and hit delete. Then what I can do is I can go to File, Save As, and we can save a copy of the file so we're not modifying the original artwork. And that concludes this tutorial lesson.